Welcome to Brick House Blue Podcast. We record this podcast in the heart of Dublin, Ohio. Today, we're excited to welcome Chief Information Officer Doug McCullough with the City of Dublin. Doug, to start off, can you maybe start to explain what a connected smart city means to the City of Dublin?
Well, I hope it means something different to us than it might mean to a different city. Lots of cities have smart city programs. It starts out with fiber and broadband and making connections in that way. But ultimately, at the end of the day, we consider connected Dublin to have to do with all sorts of people connections, connections between generations, connections between residents and their government, connections between the historic and the new. Well, like most smart cities, a lot of what we're doing has to do with mobility, transportation, a different relationship with your vehicle and your vehicle with the road. So we really start out with how people can be safer on the roads in their vehicles and also pedestrians. So there's some technology that we're using in intersections that helps us monitor and measure certain data having to do with our streets, with our parking lots, with all sorts of vehicles, and make decisions from the insights that we gain from there.
In your opinion, what makes a city, not just a smart city, but a global city of choice?
That's a great question. I've thought about this, and I think it has to do with services and amenities and, quite frankly, the feeling that people get when they visit here and they think about where do they want to move, where do they want to open their business, where do they want to locate their business. There are a lot of feelings that you can just sort of tell if you visit different places, and I believe Dublin is doing a really great job at that. You're going to get what you're looking for here in Dublin.
Absolutely, and I think that starts to speak to millennials as well, and that might be someone or a group population that Dublin is trying to attract. And they want more than just a job. They want a lifestyle. Do you think Dublin is providing the lifestyle that many are seeking now?
I do. And a lot of cities and communities and people have been trying to attract or understand millennials as a generation, as well as other generations. And there's one thing that we do here in Dublin that I think is kind of unique. We value multi-generational diversity. And I believe that millennials, in addition to all the other things we think that they may be attracted to, are also attracted to a community that feels like a community.
And also, is mobility and environment awareness a part of the 2020 Smart City Initiative for Dublin?
It is. We are concerning ourselves greatly with things like mobility, the electrification of the fleet, that's what we call people transitioning to electric cars. So we're very interested in emissions. So sustainability, the way that we use energy, what kinds of energy that we use, and what kind of data we have about the energy that we're using is a big part about being a smart city.
We've heard Dublin called the tech hub. What does this mean, again, for its residents and employers?
That's interesting. Well, for employers, it means that you're going to get access to the most important resource that you really need today. We've all heard about how artificial intelligence and robots are going to take jobs, but companies today are scrambling for people.
Right.
And communities that can attract those people and make them available to companies are winning. Mm-hmm. And so a few years ago, we had as our own goal, we recognized that companies are going to come to where the people are as opposed to the other way around. And what do we need to do to be the most attractive to knowledge workers? And that's what being a tech hub is about.
And going a little bit more into the smart city, let's start to dive in and hear a little bit more about the smart mobile corridor.
Mm-hmm.
And where are we at with that? What does the progress look like? And maybe you can tell us a little bit more about what that looks like for 2020.
It's very exciting. So the 33 Smart Mobility Corridor has participation and coordination between many different government agencies. It starts out with a bunch of fiber along a 25-mile stretch of highway on 33. And this particular stretch of highway connects the Dublin area all the way up to the Marysville area and really up to Honda and the Transportation Research Center. This infrastructure allows us to attract companies that are into smart mobility to our area to test their technologies so that we eventually get to connected and autonomous vehicles. The fiber's there, the smart mobility is there, the sensors are there, everything is there. But really, we're connecting communities to each other, to residents, to universities, to companies, and to individuals. We had an event called an Evening of Innovation in which we invited residents to come and give us feedback about these initiatives that we were planning before they're working, so that people can give us feedback about how do you feel about that. We got enormously positive feedback from the people who were there that particular evening, but that is a challenge. How do we continue to engage residents while we're putting the interesting technologies in place?
Well, our last question for this podcast, and again, thank you for being here, Doug. This has been great. We appreciate you. Is what are the goals for 2020? You've accomplished so much in 2019. You've had your challenges, and now we're in 2020. What are those goals?
Well, we're pushing the envelope. Our city council has initiated a number of visionary goals, which involve us becoming one of the most connected communities, involves us expanding our broadband access so that there's no one in the city of Dublin who doesn't have access to broadband services. We want to see more vehicles on the road that are connected vehicles. We want to see less vehicles on the road that are polluting. So we want to see more electric vehicles on the road. I can tell you that the city of Dublin is one of the greatest places to work because of these challenges. And we attract people who are attracted to big, difficult projects. And we expect to execute on many of those in 2020.